Previously on the Bill.
Dave, stop it, she's got you.
This is where he was caught sleeping, Ross.
Come on, Beth. Are you sure?
But wait a minute. What Mike did was an accident, Dave. He's just telling me what happened.
I let too many people down.
Is there somewhere where you've got to be?
I'm just bored, Rog. See, I'm like this motor. I'm built for 90, but I'm cooled around at 30.
Can you bite your fingernails or suck your thumb? Just don't take it out on my window.
Sure, mate.
Oh, that's some lousy barking.
You're going to need an ambulance, Rog.
Here, Oscar. Ambulance required on Sylvie Street.
Safe now.
On the way back to industrial estate.
Assault victim
needs urgent assistance. Over.
Saved. Oh, Stuart. We've got a van robbery out at Waybank Industrial Estate. Can you get someone to Supt Heaton to interview the driver?
Oh, Mum, I'd love to, but we're snowed under with this big fraud case at the moment. Got most of the team out turning over addresses, and I'm up to my ears with this paperwork.
Yeah, I can see that.
So maybe you can get Uniform to deal with it and then bring me the statement.
Sorry?
Mum, seriously, I'd love to deal with it, but rumour has it that the superintendent's mucking in with this one and he's gunning for a big result.
Superintendent Heaton is mucking in with CID. Now, there's a first.
Gina?
Sir?
You might be feeling a bit stretched with CID tied up.
No, we can handle it.
Actually, I thought I might join you on patrol today. Try mucking in with Uniform for a change. I wouldn't want you to feel left out.
But DS Turner's just said that you...
DS Turner's right. I am pushing for a big result. But I'm sure CID can do without me breathing down their necks for a while.
Honestly, sir, there's no need.
Oh, don't worry. I won't interfere. I'll just tag along.
Of course.
No, the last time I saw Beth and Emma, they were falling into the back of the taxi and Beth had one shoe missing.
Well, how come you're looking all right?
Because I can pace myself. I went on to a club and danced a night away and you would love
it. Was this one of your moves you just showed us in? It's terrible.
All right, show me yours.
Oh, well, then. Hey, you want to get your used to the
if you don't mind. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Where's Beth and Emma?
They're on their way. They called to say that they stopped at a domestic on the street.
Let's press on then. Canley Market, there's been a lot of complaints about petty thefts and drug dealing, so we are going to maintain a high visibility presence there today. See if we can frighten some of them off.
Sorry, Mum, our alarm didn't go off. Sorry.
As I was saying, our priority today is a high visibility presence in Canley Market.
Well, I'd be happy to take that on, Inspector. Perhaps Beth and Emma can give me the benefit of their local knowledge and demonstrate their razor-sharp skills.
Superintendent Heaton has very kindly decided to help us out today while CID are dealing with a fraud case.
Just pretend I'm not there.
Sir.
Catch you two in the rear yard in 5 minutes.
Sir. That is what you get for mixing your cocktails.
So smart.
If you can't keep up.
It is.
Good luck.
A word, please. Right. Special celebration last night, was it?
No, Mum. We just lost track of time.
Lost track of the spirit level by the smell of it. Now, I do not want you to put a foot wrong today. You represent every member of my team, understood? Now, I suggest you get to that locker room and try and smarten yourself up because you both look absolutely shambolic.
Thank you, Mum.
So you two share a flat, do you?
I'm sorry, sir?
You said you missed the alarm, I just assumed.
Oh, no, I said Emma's last night. We went to Seven Bells and then on to Kennedy's.
I don't think the superintendent's interested, Beth.
Kennedy's? Is that nightclub with 30 different types of tequila?
Yeah. Why, have you been there?
No, I'm more of a single malt man myself.
Oh, fancy getting some fresh air in Canley Market? You'll be doing me a favour.
I think I should drive, don't you?
He's in one of his meet the public days, and that lot's a shambles this morning. I need someone to help me keep an eye on him.
You mean help you keep an eye on him? Keeping an eye on them?
I'm on that transparent.
I'll get my stuff.
All right.
All walks of life here, don't they?
It's a nice market. I come in most Saturdays. There's a good store at the end that sells designer copies, bags, belts, stuff like that.
Beth.
I'm sure that no one on this market would ever dream of selling counterfeit stock, Emma. Just as sure as I am that Beth would never dream of buying any.
No, it's not counterfeit, it's copies. They don't use the same labels. You should have a look, so you might find a bargain for your wife.
I'm sure the superintendent's wife doesn't want any of your dodgy market fare.
No, I suppose she's got a really expensive taste. Not that you can't afford it. I'm not saying you're rich, I just...
I should quit while you're here, Beth.
Lee. What are you doing here on a school day?
Been giving the morning off. Mum had to go to the dentist, I'm just covering for now.
This is Superintendent Heaton. This is Lee Gunter. His mum owns a store, he's normally here on Saturdays.
Yeah, I'm only missing geography, so Mum said it'd be okay.
You should be at school though, shouldn't you, Lee?
It's just an hour, I swear. We'll be back in time for maths, but if we don't open up first thing, we lose the pitch.
Oh, I shouldn't think an hour off school's going to harm Lee's future hopes in an education too much. Just make sure you go back to school when she returns.
Half this market's up to something dodgy. And it wouldn't surprise me if the super called in every other stall holder for trading standards.
He seems pretty chipper today.
Yeah, that's what terrifies me.
Okay, so I feel distinctly ropey. Remind me again while we went into Slammers.
Sally's full. What is he looking at?
Michael Bolton, Phil Collins, a little bit of Cliff. Right, sir?
Look at this, it's fantastic, this is. Real music. Jimi Hendrix.
Jimmy who?
I think I'll get this for the drive to work.
You don't know who Jimi Hendrix is?
No, should I?
Windpipe,
isn't it? It's like the super fans did a bit of shopping.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Sierra Oscar 1 from Sierra 1.
Go ahead, Roger.
Wayne Darby's now been treated as St. Hughes and is ready to make a statement.
All right, get yourself back to the station and report to D.S. Turner. I'm on patrol here in Candy Market.
Will do, Mum. Over.
If they so much as sneeze, I'm going to murder them today.
It's just one of my regular jobs. Load up in Liverpool, and the street run to deliver at the warehouse.
What goods do you carry?
Whatever the warehouse is ordered. We supply all the discount stores on the high streets, so it's never the same thing twice.
So what happened this morning?
I came out onto the waybank. This motorbike speeds up in front of me and loses its back end. So I slam on the brakes and start mouthing off at the driver. Next thing I know, this fella opens the door, drags me out the cab onto the tarmac.
Did you get a good look in?
No, it was all over too quick. Hit me on the sides of the head, then dragged me down the back.
What about the bike? Did you get a look at the rider?
Has a helmet on. The bike was a big blue thing. Jap, probably. About a 750.
What happened then?
It taped up my hands and my legs. Taped up my mouth. Threw me in the back of the van. And then started loading up. He has a big white van. Must have just come up from behind.
I don't suppose he got the registration?
No.
Is there anything else you can remember about them?
No.
OK, we'll check your inventory list, see what's been stolen. And we'll let the warehouse know what's happened.
Thank you.
They do a great bacon roll there, sir.
It's a little early for refs, don't you think, Beth?
3 o'clock.
Are we starving by then?
No, Beth, 3 o'clock.
There's a drugs dealer over us, Orman. You two head down there and double back. I'll leave 10 seconds before I move in.
Sierra Oscar 1 from 5-2.
Possible drugs deal taking place.
Suspect heading towards you.
Black leather jacket and beanie.
Received, over.
Three, six, one for 5-2. Suspect heading your way. Purple hoodie.
All received, over.
Excuse me, miss.
Excuse me. Oh. 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 Oh.
Excuse me, miss. Excuse
me. No!
Listen, it's all right.
Don't touch me!
It's all right. I'm not touch me!
Just... You're going to hurt me!
Okay. Just one word with you, all right?
Just calm down. No one's trying to hurt you.
I saw her making a deal.
And I found this on him, cannabis resin.
I asked her for a word and she just went crazy.
You touched me! You didn't have to touch me!
Okay, calm down, please. What's your name?
Rachel Compton.
Okay, Rachel, look, no one is going to hurt you.
He did.
Did you get the other boy?
No, so it was too fast and strong.
What, for both of you?
Yeah, sorry, sir. He's yours.
Come. Who's the other boy, Rachel? Is he your supplier?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
Rachel Compton, I'm arresting your suspicious.
I saw Rachel give the other boy something just before he ran off. It was probably the rest of her drug supply. If you can't find anything on her now, I want a strip search back at the station.
Okay, Rachel, can you take your jacket off, please? Right, and your top, please. How'd you get those, Rachel? Did someone do that to you?
It's private.
Right, well, can you take your bra off now, please?
We're going to need to interview you shortly, and because you're 16, we require an appropriate adult. Can I call you Mum?
She's dead.
What about your dad?
Never knew him. You could try my brother. His number's in my phone under Matty.
Matty, right.
Right, Rachel, put your bra and top back on, please. And I'm sorry I'm going to have to ask you to do this, but can you take your skirt and tights off, please?
Here's your radio, sir. Are you okay?
Well, since you ask, Beth, no, not really. I don't feel particularly good about scaring a young woman half to death, no matter what she's done. And I can't understand how her accomplice managed to outrun two fit young officers.
Well, he did push Beth over, sir.
How about you, Emma? Perhaps it'd be best if you concentrated less on your hangovers and more on your work.
Sarge?
Yes?
I checked the missing stock against Wayne Darby's inventory and got a list of the stuff stolen from this morning's robbery. Some DVD players, digital radios, battery-operated robot toys.
Oh, do you want to swap it for this fraud case?
Listen, mate, I can't spare anyone to deal with that right now. Circulate the details to uniform, the surrounding boroughs. Check the usual places, you know, market stores, cash converters, you know.
Come on.
Yeah, all right, get someone to drop a list off down at Canley Market. The superintendent's down there with Beth and Emma. They can keep an eye out. Go on.
Sure.
Right, well, I found no previous on Rachel, but the brother Matty, I ran a check just to be on the safe side. And there's no involvement in drugs, but there was a long spell on youth offenders for GBH. And the mother died of a smack overdose when they were both kids. So they were brought up in foster care till Rachel turned 16, which was 9 months ago.
Sarge, I've got Matty Compton calling
you. Oh, thanks, Sally. Hello, I'm Sergeant Nikki Wright. This is Inspector Gina Gold.
It's Rachel Wright.
Well, she got very distressed when our superintendent tried to arrest her.
Is your superintendent a guy?
He is.
Yeah, well, she don't like being touched, particularly by men. Is she okay?
Well, we are concerned about her. I'm afraid we had to do a strip search, and we did notice some scars. Is there a history of abuse?
No offence, but that ain't really any of your business.
Listen to me. She's very on the edge. Now, to your knowledge, is she a user?
We lost our mum to heroin. There's no way she'd touch any drugs. The only drug she's on is medication for anxiety and depression. If she doesn't take her meds, then she can become very anxious.
That's right. So, is it possible that she may have stopped taking her medication?
I wouldn't know. I haven't seen her for like 3 months, not since she moved in with her boyfriend.
Right, she's in here. So, tell us what happened at the market.
There's nothing to tell. I didn't do anything and your boss grabbed me.
Well, why lash out at him?
He grabbed me from behind. I don't like that.
You didn't have to kick him though, Rach.
Superintendent Heaton said he saw you sell the drugs to our other suspect, Ronnie Charles, who has also confirmed that you sold him approximately 1 ounce of cannabis resin. And then
When you saw Superintendent Heaton approaching, you seemingly offloaded something to another young man in a purple hoodie. Now, is this your drug supply?
He's wrong. I never.
Who was the other boy, Rachel?
Someone, some bloke. He asked me for a light and I gave him a book of matches. That's it. That's it.
So you don't know him and you didn't give him any drugs?
No, look, if you're going to charge me with selling some dope to Ronnie Childs or whatever his name is, then do, but otherwise let me go home. I just want to go home.
Let's get you processed, and it could take some time, and then you can go home, right?
Are you the one that searched her?
Oh, well, we both did. What happened to her?
5 years ago, we got split up from foster care. I was too old, I was 16. So I had to leave her with the family. And there was this other lad there who tried to... Do you know what? Forget it. I shouldn't have said anything.
Did this boy abuse her? She can still get help, you know. Did she report him?
She didn't have to. I took care of it. How do you think I wound up inside?
Here we are, Rog. Let's see what this owner's got to say about these stolen goods. Excuse me. Tell us where we can find Jazz to sign.
He's just inside there. Jeez.
In your own time, Rog.
Well, that explains a lot. I've been waiting on that delivery since 9 o'clock.
Do you think your stock delivery may have been targeted specifically, Mr. Dessart?
Of course not. Why would anyone be targeting my gear? Just got unlucky. Can't win them all.
Well, how about any disgruntled employees who may want to get back here?
Show me a warehouse worker who ain't disgruntled. The driver not get a good description of him?
Well, nothing we can use. It's just two blokes, one on a blue motorbike, the other in a white van.
He's a bright spark, that Wayne, isn't he? I'm surprised you haven't caught him already.
For your information, Wayne took quite a beating. It was hardly his fault. Do you mind if we speak to your staff? One of them may have accidentally discussed your delivery schedules. You never know.
Knock yourself out. Look, to be honest, brother, I'm not bothered who did it. I just want my stuff back. We don't exactly run on big profit margins here.
We're doing all we can, Mr. Dessart. If we could just have a word with your staff.
Go for it. In the meantime, I've got to find some replacement stock.
Charming.
Well, who knows? We might get lucky and find out it's an insurance scam, and we can nick the arrogant gift. I'll go that way.
Anything?
No, sir, nothing.
I think our presence is frightening them off, sir.
Roger and Nate just stopped by. This is an inventory of the items stolen in the van robbery this morning. Some of them might have been sold on already, so we should keep an eye out. Now, read it properly, Beth. This is serious. Somebody got hurt this morning.
Aha! Sir. 12 DVD players, 24 digital radios, 2 boxes of retro robot toys and 36 water purifiers.
I know. It's like a circus act, isn't it?
Right, sure.
Yeah.
Oh!
This is a bad time, Sarge?
No, we're just catching up with some paperwork.
Well, sorry to bother you, Sarge. We've just been talking to Jazz Desai, the bloke who had his stuff nicked in the van robbery this morning. According to his employees, the business isn't doing very well. They've all had their wages late.
Oh, great. More paperwork.
Oh, just keep me up to speed, Sarge. We'll do some digging ourselves. I'll get someone to ring FIU and then we'll check out the alibis of the staff from this morning.
Yeah, thanks, Rog. Appreciate that.
We need to go this way.
Please. Don't mind us.
Okay, thanks very much. Well, nothing serious on Jazz Desai. He had a bit of a slump a couple of years back.
Cool, FIU business has been picking up ever since.
Yeah, well, at least you found something. I've been trying through the CCTV for hours, and I'm telling you, mate, there is nothing to link any motorcycles or vans. Whoever chose this location knew there were camera blind spots.
Look, I'm going to have a word with Roger. I'll come back and give you a hand, yeah?
Yeah, sure.
Lee, I thought we had a deal. 1 hour, then back to school. Where's your mum?
Oh, I'm really sorry. She didn't feel good after the dentist, so I sent her home for a lie down. 20 minutes to lunch. I'll be back in time for afternoon lessons.
Well, maybe we should give your mum a ring. She shouldn't be encouraging you.
Oh, please don't. She really doesn't feel well, and I promise her I'll be okay. Yeah, they're great, aren't they? Look, it also does that. Kids love them. I've only got 2 left. I can do you a deal if you want.
Where did you get this?
I don't know, a supplier.
The serial numbers match the ones on the list.
Well, how do you know?
Sorry, silly question.
Did your mum buy these, Lee?
No. I got them this morning. Some man was selling them out of a bag.
Did he sell you anything else?
No, just the robots, honest.
Look, Lee, I'm really sorry. We're going to have to ask you to come down the station and answer a few questions. You better give us both the robots.
Right, whoever's nicked this stuff, he's certainly getting rid of it very, very quickly.
I've checked the stolen property list. The robots are the only things that match.
Well, Ben and Tony have had no joy with the CCTV. There's no coverage of the actual site of the robbery, and we haven't found a blue bike anywhere nearby or a white van.
Which is starting to cast doubt on Wayne's story.
Well, he was beaten and gagged. He could have been mistaken.
So basically, we got nothing from the scene. Okay, well, I reckon the best thing for us to do is to have a word with this boy Lee, see what he can tell us about who he got the robots from.
Haven't been able to get hold of his mum, by the way.
Okay, well, Beth and I will talk to him. You know him best, so that'll help him to open up. Beth, you could lead the interview.
Where did you buy the robots, Lee?
I said, didn't I? Some bloke offered me a dozen this morning, £5 each.
And what did this bloke look like?
I don't remember.
Come on, Lee, you're a smart kid. You know, receiving stolen goods is a serious offence. You're lucky we didn't have you arrested. Your mum could lose her market licence.
No, don't take this out on my mum.
Well, then talk to me, Lee. You work that market like a natural. You must have some information. It'll work to your advantage.
What, like a deal?
You tell us where you bought them robots. Cooperate fully, and we take you straight back to school. No caution, no charge. No one on the market need know. We might not have to tell your mum.
Okay. His name was James. I didn't get a surname.
What did he look like?
He was tall, jeans, purple hoodie.
Well, that sounds familiar. Did he have a girl with him?
Nah, he was on his own. Said he had a load of stuff to shift. DVDs, digital radios. I'm short on petty cash and I'm up to my ears in that stuff already, so I just locked the robots, so I took half a dozen of them.
What happened to the others? Have you sold them? Lee.
Some other guy came an hour later, said they were his and he wanted them back. I told him he had to pay for them because I bought them legit. He asked who from and I said it wasn't my style to squeal on someone. Then he put his hands around my throat.
Then?
I gave him James's name and mobile number. He took the four robots I had on display. He didn't know about the other two under the counter.
And what did he look like?
He was Asian, quite old, a bit younger than you.
Can we have James's number?
This deal, right, we've made it, it's solid now, no charges or caution.
Not if you're holding something back from us, Lee. Did he give you a second name?
No, I promise, just a first name and number, in case I wanted any more stock.
Okay, then. Looks like we've got a deal.
His number's in my phone, I'll give it to you.
Well done, Lee. We'll take your statement here, then I'll get PC Keane to give you a lift back to school.
Excellent, she's hot.
Any luck with that mobile number?
Well, James isn't too bright, sir. His mobile's under contract, so I got a full name and address from his service provider. James Maguire, 23 Luxford Road. Shoplifting, handling stolen goods, a couple of offences for dealing marijuana.
Well, that fits. Looks like it could be the same guy who ran off after the drugs deal this morning.
We're heading over there now, sir.
Unless, of course, sir.
No, no, it's your arrest. Go ahead.
Then, am I going to have to come in there and glue you to your desk?
I made a deal with your boss. I'm not going back on it.
Well, make sure you don't, okay?
He's all right, Superintendent. You know, for a copper.
Yeah, he has his moments. I'm getting to school. What?
Have your phone number first?
Yeah. It's 999. Let's go.
James Maguire? James Maguire? James? You all right? What's your name, son?
Matty Compton.
All right, all right. Let's have a look.
Robots from our inquiries. None of them have got any batteries.
Sierra, Oscar from Sierra 1. The assault victim at Lux Rose on his way to St. Hugh's. Can you get someone over there to interview him, please? We'll be searching the premises.
I don't understand this. Most of the stolen gear is gone, apart from the robots, and James Maguire is missing. This is his place. Where is he?
It's not just his place. It's posted here for Rachel Compton.
My victim's Matty Compton, so I'm guessing brother and sister. Well, this must be James and Rachel. So let's circulate their description to all units. And with all this evidence, we can at least put James Maguire in the frame for the van robbery.
What do you reckon? Matty and James did the job, then had a row about how to split the gear.
It's a theory. What I don't get is what the robots did wrong.
So, how are you feeling?
I've had worse.
You up to talking?
I suppose. There's not much I can tell you, though.
Well, how about why you're in James Maguire's place for a start?
He's Rachel's boyfriend. They live together. I took her home after you let her go.
So you're a friend of James?
No, I wouldn't say that. He goes out with my sister. It doesn't mean I have to like him.
Did James do this to you?
No, he wasn't home. I went in to confront him about Rachel selling drugs. She didn't have to say a thing. I knew that he put her up to it.
Right, well, why don't you tell us what happened?
I took Rachel home. She offered me a brew, only she didn't have any milk, so she went out to get some, and the next thing I know, two blokes rush in, and they start laying into me.
Well, can you give us a description of them?
No, I'm sorry. They all happened so fast. I reckon that they must have thought that I was James.
What makes you think that?
Well, it's not my flat for a start, and I'm not the one swimming around in a flat full of knocked-off gear.
So you know all about that stuff, then?
He's got a load of electrical gear still in boxes in his flat. I'm not stupid.
Well, do you mind telling us where you were at 6:25 this morning?
Arriving at work. Why?
Can anyone confirm that?
About a dozen people. One of them a copper down at Barton Street. Look, I work on a programme helping young offenders. I'm pretty well qualified for the job.
Well, we'll check that out. Would you like us to call Rachel for you?
No, I'll call her myself.
Okie doke, you rest now. Thank you. Do you think he's in it with Jones?
I'm not sure. He seems a bit jumpy. I reckon his alibi's going to check out, though.
My eyes are killing me. Any of you guys seen spots yet?
Certainly not seeing any motorcycles. It's in the last of the cameras.
You know, I think I might have something, guys.
Oh, yeah?
This Honda, it passes here at 6:20 this morning.
I never really took any notes of it before, but then I was looking for a motorbike and a white van, but... Here, it's 10 minutes later.
Well, you see, it's really heavily loaded at the back. Whereas in the first shot, it doesn't look as though it's got anything in it at all.
Yeah, but I was supposed to be looking for two blokes. I mean, that's a woman passenger seat, isn't it?
Yeah. That's James Maguire and Rachel Compton. I recognise them from photos.
Oh, I've got something. Look, these two jokers driving past in the direction of James's flat 10 minutes before the assault on Matty Compton.
Slowing down, like they're looking for something. That looks like Wayne Darby and Jazz Desai. I'll do a vehicle registration check to make sure.
5 minutes after the assault, they're off again.
Bingo! Vehicle registered to one Jazz Desai. So, Wayne lied in his statement about the robbery. No bike, no two guys. Then he and Jazz head over to James's place, give Matty a pasting, thinking he's James, but leave behind the stolen robots. Weird. Better put the inspector in the loop.
So, James and Rachel stopped the van at 6:25 this morning. Half an hour later, James was in Canley Market, selling on six of the stolen robot toys to Lee Gunn. An hour after that, we saw James and Rachel together in the market, just after we'd seen Rachel dealing drugs. Now, she handed something to James when she saw me coming, probably her drug supply, and then he ran off. At 12 noon, Wayne Darby and Jazz Desai are seen on CCTV in the vicinity of James Maguire's flat. Later on, Roger and Nate found Matty Compton badly beaten inside the flat.
So Jazz could have seen Lee selling some of the stolen goods at the market and threatened him into giving up James's contact number.
Okay, so what then?
Well, Jazz must have inquired about buying some of the stolen goods, maybe as a way of getting his address, then went straight over there.
Well, why take everything else but the robots?
Well, hang on, these robot toys, only some of them were smashed open. The rest have had their fronts ripped off.
So what are you thinking?
Well, it's like Jazz was looking for something. We've still got the two that Lee gave us in the property store.
That's good, Beth. Let's you and me go and check them out.
Well, that's a double act I never saw coming.
That's not a regulation issue, is it, sir?
It is in Switzerland. Batteries.
We'll try the other one. That might be the one that Lee had on display.
Looks like heroin. That explains why Jazz smashed up the robots and didn't bother with the rest of the stolen goods. He was after something much more valuable.
Robot drug mules.
We haven't accounted for all the rest of the stock yet. There are children's toys out on the street with bags of heroin in them.
Now that heroin's involved, shouldn't we pass this over to CID, sir?
Usually, yes, but we've come this far. I think we deserve to see it through. Don't need to bother CID with it yet.
All right. Where do you want to start? Jazz Desire's warehouse?
I don't want to show our hand if Jazz doesn't have the drugs. We don't know the drugs were at James's house when Jazz and Wayne beat Matty up. Well, James could have found them before Jazz got there. Has anybody located James or Rachel yet?
Well, neither of them are answering their mobiles and neither of them have turned up at home yet. Which is odd, because Matty told me that Rachel only went out for some milk.
Okay, let's put some surveillance on Jazz Desai and see where he leads us. Also, we should have another word with Matty. He may be covering for Rachel.
Okay, I'll call that you.
Oh, yes, from Sierra Oscar, report of a missing 14-year-old boy by his mother. His name is Lee Gunn. I see one, 5 feet tall, brown hair, blue sweatshirt.
I thought you dropped him off back at school.
Yeah, I did. Sarah Oscar from 361.
Sir?
Matty Compton's discharged himself.
After that beating, he's going to want to get his own back, isn't he? And he's worried about Rachel as well.
Right, get that surveillance team down to Jazz's now in case Matty turns up there.
Yep.
Also, have Roger and Nate in an unmarked car outside Matty's house. If he goes anywhere, I want them to follow him. Beth, come with me.
What makes you think he's gone missing, Mrs. Gunn? I dropped him off at school at lunchtime myself.
You did? Why?
Well, it's complicated. He's not in any big trouble.
Oh, yes, he is. I had a letter today telling me I had to go up to the school to talk about him truanting.
Right. So it's a regular thing, is it? Oh,
apparently. Not that I knew. The last thing I needed today was the trouble of going all the way up there.
Yeah. Tooth still hurting, is it?
Sorry?
Your tooth? The dentist this morning?
I hadn't been to the dentist.
Right, well, he told us that's why he was minding your stall.
Our stall?
I assumed you'd looked there for him already.
I shut our stall down 6 weeks ago when I went into hospital to have a tumour removed, and what with the chemo. So, I'm sorry, love, I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, Mrs. Gunn, I'm pretty sure we'll find him at your stall, so do you feel up to me taking you down there?
Try and stop me.
He doesn't look so happy.
5-2 from 595. We've eyeballed Wayne and Jazz. Looks like there's a bit of tension between them. Jazz doesn't look like a man who's lost his drugs and found them again.
Okay, thanks, Tony.
Ready, sir.
Good. 876 from 5-2, any sign of Matty Compton?
He came home then left straight away, sir. We've got him in our sights.
We'll keep you informed, over.
Okay, let's go. So, Beth, what lies ahead for you?
Sorry, sir.
Where do you see yourself heading professionally?
Oh, I haven't really thought about it, to be honest. I'm enjoying what I'm doing now, and I'm still learning, so I guess I'll see how I feel at the end of my probation.
You should have more faith in your ability. You're a good officer doing a good job, despite what happened this morning.
Thanks, sir.
Five, two, he stopped at a cash point on the High Street. He's using another card. He's getting a lot of cash out, sir. Whatever he's buying, it's pretty expensive. He's heading up the High Street towards Melling Road. The traffic's pretty heavy up there, sir.
Thanks, Nate. On our way. Beth and I will pick him up.
What are you doing here?
Get the words out of my mouth. Why aren't you at school?
You didn't squeal on me.
Don't be cheeky to the officer. I asked you a question.
Well, someone's got to keep the stool open, so you don't worry.
I told you, love, we just couldn't keep it open while I was recovering.
Did you ever officially close the stool down?
Well, I never actually posted the letters to the market inspector.
What?
So, you've been coming here every day without your mum knowing?
Yeah. I couldn't even get that right after this morning, could I?
It's just a stool, Lee. I don't need you getting in trouble for me.
Sorry.
I had to tell her about the stolen goods, but she knows it's not your fault.
Come here, you soft lump. I don't know whether to hug you to death or strangle you.
Shall I have a word with the market manager? See if he'll secure your pitch until you get better.
There's not much you can do. There's nothing protecting it.
Oh, I don't know. I've noticed about 15 different infringements of the law since I arrived here this morning.
Thanks. It's appreciated.
Listen, you. Get your store packed up. Take your mother home. And if you want to help, put the kettle on and do a bit of washing up now and then, okay?
Do what?
You heard. I'll be keeping an eye on you, okay?
Car from the robbery this morning.
Nice change of quiet.
PCs Valentine
and Roberts, stand by to move in.
Received.
Over.
Looks like James did get to the drugs before Jazz decided after all. But why is Matty buying them? Right, that's the sale. Let's go. You get Maguire, I'll get Matty.
Police! Get off him! Stop it!
Calm down!
I've got to get out of here!
Not now, you're not
going to... I have to! They've got my sister, Rachel! And they took her after they gave me the kick in!
Don't steal!
Look, if I don't get the drugs to them in the next hour, they're going to kill her!
Okay, time is short, so listen up. Matty Compton has given us a full statement about what happened at James Maguire's flat this lunchtime. Jazz Desai and Wayne Darby broke into the flat looking for their heroin, which was stashed in the robots. And when they couldn't find it, they beat Matty up, kidnapped his sister, and told him to get the drugs to them by 6 o'clock today. Now, that gives us 45 minutes. Now, in view of the seriousness of the situation, I have asked DS Turner and DC Moss to assist us.
OK, thank you, sir. Right, Desai's warehouse. Now, there's a sizable car park out the front, entrances front and back. Now, we've got two priorities today. The first, keep Rachel Compton safe. The second, arrest Jazz Desai and his mate Wayne Darby in possession of the drugs. Now, we don't know how Jazz is going to play this. All we've heard from Matthew Compton is he's supposed to turn up at the store at 6 o'clock, so be prepared to improvise. Has anyone actually spoken to Jazz or Wayne?
You two stay out of sight until the off.
Well, I'll need two people covering the back ready to go in and pinpoint Rachel too.
Okay, Beth and I can take that.
Okay, myself and Stevie will wait in the car park. I'll need another two officers there too, Mum. Just in case they try to make off in a vehicle. Sir, how was Matthew Compton's mood when you spoke to him?
He was very angry and very worried about his sister. The longer she goes without her medication, the worse she'll be. I would also say that Matty is likely to be highly volatile, so I'd like to get him off the scene as soon as the exchange is made. Okay, let's go. Right, Matty.
In position.
In position.
He's just doing what he's told.
Where is he? Where's the site? No, you ain't getting these until I see him.
Oh, what are you doing?
Play nicely, Matty.
I told you, where is he?
Oh, come on.
All units move in. Go, go, go.
Stop! Elise, stay with me!
Right, stay with me, Beth. Rachel's got to be in here somewhere. Jazz.
Look, girl, what are you talking about?
Don't even think about it. Where is she?
Take me on your back.
Check his pockets.
Come on. On your feet. On your feet.
Just as I am arresting you for abduction and a conspiracy to supply and drugs.
Rachel, it's okay. I'm PC Beth Green. Can you take this off?
Rachel, I'm going to cut you free now, all right? Now, I'll try not to touch you, but if I do, just try to stay calm, all right? I'm afraid I am going to have to arrest you in connection with a van robbery this morning. Do you understand? But we'll get you checked out first. I'm now showing the suspect a still photo taken from CCTV footage of him in his car on the Waybank Estate at 6:20 this morning.
I was taking Rachel shopping down the market.
And 10 minutes later, you drove back. What about the boxes in the back of the car?
Recycling. I was taking them up the tip.
Well, how do you explain the stolen goods we found in your flat? Goods stolen from a van just after you drove past it this morning.
Matty must have taken them around. I wasn't there when you found them, was I?
So why did he bring the stuff to your flat?
Rachel's his sister. She lives there too, remember? Ask her.
Rachel, the driver of the van that was robbed this morning has identified you as the person who flagged him down.
You listening to this?
And then this afternoon, we found some of the stolen goods at the flat that you share with James. Now, are you still trying to tell us that James isn't involved?
Yeah.
Why don't you tell us the truth? We know you're trying to protect him.
I don't want to talk to you. Please, why can't Matty be here?
He's going over his statement with another police officer.
I want James then.
Well, I'm afraid James is under arrest, the same as you are. Look, why are you protecting James? Because he's not protecting you.
That's not true.
Are you scared of him, Rachel?
No. Why would I be scared of him? I love him. He's the only bloke who's never let me down.
Well, what about Matty? He's never let you down, has he?
Yeah, he did. He went away. He left me in the foster home as soon as he was 16. He left me with him.
Left you with who, Rachel?
My foster brother. Matty didn't care.
Rachel, do you know why Matty went to prison?
Because he can't control his temper. He beat some bloke up in a pub.
That bloke was your foster brother. Matty put him into hospital after what he did to you. And I've checked Matty's records. He doesn't give any reason why. He just wanted to protect you so that you didn't end up in court. Now, I'm not saying that what he did was right, but he ended up doing 3 years for you. And today, when Matty knew that Jazz had taken you, he was prepared to take the risk of going back to prison by doing a major drug deal just to get you back. And what did your boyfriend do when Matty asked for the drugs to get you back?
He made Matty pay for the drugs that were going to save your life. Does that sound like he cares?
You're lying.
Sorry, darling, it's true.
Rachel, please. Please tell us what happened today. The truth about James's involvement.
It was all James's idea.
Right. Go on.
He'd been making me sell some jewelry on the market for a while. But he thought we could make bigger money.
By robbing a delivery van?
We were just going to hold it up. Steal the stuff and sell it on. When I was messing about with one of them robots, it didn't work, so I opened it up to check the battery in. There were the drugs.
And then you found more drugs in other robots.
James thought we'd hit the jackpot, but I didn't want anything to do with it. Not after Mum. I knew it was heroin.
And what did James want to do?
He said we could make a fortune. He said we could go away and get a new life.
Thank you, Rach.
And now can I see Matty?
Rach!
Matty. It's okay, I've told him the truth about James.
Look, it's okay. Go ahead.
I was so scared. I didn't think I was going to see you again. But I promise, I'll take care of you now.
I always knew she was a useless nutter. You're a waste of space.
We accounted for all the missing robots.
She's been very helpful. James sold only 4 robots before they found the drugs to some pawnbrokers in the high street. Nate and Roger are picking them up now.
Excellent.
Will you be joining us again tomorrow, sir?
You can relax, Gina. I think I've done enough mucking in for a while. Good work today, Beth. Seriously. Well done.
Thanks. Nice.
Gina?
Sir?
Next time, on the bill.
Go on, get out! Get out! Run, you!
Is that coke?
No chance you can lose.
What? No, no way.
Any drugs on them when they were searched?
No.
What are you thinking?
I have really screwed up, and I don't know what to do.